Hello, and welcome to Let's Play Popful Male Redux, episode number 4. My name is Duke of the Bump, and I will be your guide on this ridiculous journey of a young woman named Popful Male to defeat the evil wizard Muttonhead.
Male, it's you! Oh, I thought I was to be trapped here forever. Quick, pull that lever on your left. It opens the cell door.
You haven't seen Muttonhead lately, have you?
Quiet! We don't have time for that. Just pull the lever and let's get out of here.
I've got all the time in the world. So fess up. Have you seen him or not?
Mayo, let me out of here and I'll tell you what I know about my teacher's location. Fair enough?
Okay, but remember, you promised.
I don't think he did promise.
Now then, Junior. Where's Muttonhead?
I don't know for sure, but I think he's probably in his hideout.
Ooh, yellow text. That's important.
I'll take you there, but I have to warn you. It's really quite dangerous.
Lead the way, I guess.
That's it, Male. The dreaded Wind Cave, one of the most dangerous places in the land, just crawling with monsters.
Tad, I'm not afraid. It'll be a great test of my fighting skill.
We must be very cautious, ma'am. Muttonhead is no ordinary magician.
I know he's hiding in there. I can feel it. And when I find him, he's all mine. Then I can collect that big fat reward. No time to lose. Let's go.
All right, and that takes us to the next area of the game. I hope that was loud enough for you guys to hear. There aren't any subtitles or anything during the actual animated cutscenes. So yeah, let's go on ahead and save up. I hope you enjoyed the previous video. Oh, damn it.
Yourself some trouble and go and play with your dollies instead. If you know
more sexism in video games,
you'll take my advice.
I know what's good for me. The 2 million on your head. Your threats don't scare me, you old prune.
The incompetence you have shown here is inexcusable.
Uh-huh.
The golem I have given you is now a twisted wreckage. Your punishment will be severe.
No, please wait, I'll...
It's Kazer, apparently. I don't know who Kazer is, but his name's in yellow, so it must be important.
What, may I ask, was that?
Good question, Mail. Whoa, jump cut. Sorry about that, guys. I turned the volume up during the voice cutscenes to make them a little bit easier to hear, and I forgot to turn it down afterwards this time, because there were like a billion cutscenes in a row. So, there were a couple minutes there where the sound was overpowering me, so I'm going to re-record that part. But you're not missing much. I did not say anything of particular interest. This is Tap. This is the second character of three that you unlock through the progression of the game. And I prefer him to Male by a wide margin. He is slower, which some might see as a disadvantage. But in my opinion, Male just moves too quickly. You don't have a chance to react. Because by the time you get to an enemy, you're already walking into it. And with Tat, you have a little bit more time to react. Now, there are times where you need Male's speed, and she comes in handy, and I'll be switching to her. And I'll probably also switch to her for some of the dialogue options, because they recorded different dialogue, depending on which character you're playing. When you get to a certain point in the game. This is my later save here. I went ahead and recorded over that one. So yeah, that's interesting. Male's dialogue is usually the best. Just, it's the most over-the-top, crazy antics, kind of manic pixie dream girl stuff. No, that's the wrong trope. Not really a manic pixie dream girl. She's more of the spunky type. You know, that's the default characterizations in this kind of fantasy anime stuff. Is, you know, there's the shy, reserved girl, or there's the spunky girl. And it's pretty much one of those two. And, I mean, not that there's anything wrong with spunk, it's just kind of a one-dimensional character arc. That direction off to the left was a hot springs, and we cannot actually... I'm in trouble. Okay. I'm okay. We can't go that way yet. So I'm going to go on ahead and head off to the right here. Really wish I didn't take that damage. Screw it. Now, you do have individual life bars, so that's one benefit of having multiple characters. That's another thing that would cause me to switch to male instead of tat. Or the third character, who we should be unlocking fairly soon. Don't know if we'll get him in this video, but if not, the next video or the video after that. There's not going to be another boss for a pretty good while, so I'm not sure. I forgot you can actually drop through the platforms. Durr. Yeah, the next boss isn't going to be for a bit. I'm not sure if we're actually going to fight a boss in this video. We'll have to wait and see how quickly I can get to the next event. I'm making pretty good time. Oh.
Slick? What in the world are you doing here? You're not lost again, are you?
Hey, listen. I am not lost. I was just out exploring. After you left me totally vulnerable and alone in the tree, which wasn't very cool at all, I decided to set
out. I thought you had a pocket knife.
It's something every man has to do for himself.
But?
Well, I got this far, all by myself, you know, but the exit to this cave is, sort of being blocked right now by a big rock. That's just a small crimp in my master plan, though.
And how do you expect to get past?
Hey, don't worry. I don't want or even need anything from you. With this tinfoil, paperclip, used gum, and bat droppings, I've crafted a bomb that's sure to blow this blockage to bits. Kids, don't try this at home. This bomb is being detonated under controlled conditions with no parental supervision. Assuming you could find the bat droppings, attempting to duplicate this feat in the real world could result in serious eye damage, or one heck of a stinky mess.
Thanks. That's advice anyone can use.
Don't walk, flea brain, run! You're going to be crushed.
I'm scared. I don't want to die. Please, you gotta help me.
Look out! Great job, numbskull. Your little homemade plan backfired, and now you're trapped.
What a smell! Those bat droppings, you're back.
You seem a little too pleased about that, Slick.
Are you completely retarded?
Ooh,
don't you know
not
we
cool.
could have been killed?
Hey, why are you calling me retarded?
And what else do you expect me to do?
Well, you could find a way to get me out of here.
Oh, sure. Now you want my help. Well, I guess I'm forced to help you because I need to get past your little landslide. But don't get the idea that we're buds now, Mr. Slick.
Is it just me or does she have kind of a Northwestern American accent? Oh, I need to get past your little landslide. I don't know if that's a good impression, but not Northwestern, but, like, Midwestern, like Wisconsin and Minnesota, North Dakota, and that area. Kind of a, if you've ever seen Fargo, kind of a similar thing to that. And it's not very pronounced, but I think I detected a little bit of it in there. Alright, so this part is annoying. We have to go back to the hot springs. Well, that area, not the hot springs themselves, but where that sign was. But we still can't go that way. We just need to trigger the event that allows us to come back here that would allow us to get past that area. Yeah, there's kind of a lot of that unnecessary backtracking stuff in this game. Unnecessary because I know, as the player, what I need to do. And I can't just say, hey Slick, before I go back, you need to hook me up with something. And you'll find out what it is in a second. Yeah, I'd still better stick with mail because Tat is down pretty low. I have a pretty good bit of money. I need to stock up on some apples. What I like to do is buy about 10 of them, which I should be able to afford along with all the new equipment in the next town. Hopefully. I don't know. It might be more expensive than I'm remembering. Here we go. And I'm staggering my saves just in case something happens. Oh my god, something like that happens. Yeah. Oh yeah, great, okay. I'm not going to try to get back up there manually. I guess what I really need to do is back up my original save, because if FS Split crashes, I don't have a backup of the save from the point that I started at. Which means I would have to backtrack and redo all that stuff manually, which would be good because... Oh wait, that's not a cutscene. It would be good because I'd have a whole lot of extra money, but it would just be a little bit of a pain in the ass, and not totally natural.
Hey, little fella, don't run away. I won't bite. There's been a cave-in, and a boy is trapped. Can you help me get him out of there? If he was the one using bombs in our cave, he deserved to be buried.
Ooh, snap. Okay, well, that's discouraging. Let's head back and see what Slick has to say, I guess. Save. So yeah, I'm trying to do this, you know, as naturally as possible. No save states, no... Oh my god, no frame skip. Just, good old-fashioned... gumption. I don't know. Good old-fashioned whatever. I hate this part. Oh god. If I had tried to jump past this snail, then I would have hit that snail, but I hit him anyway, and it's a big mess. Okay, well, hopefully I can make it to the next town, because it's pretty close. I just have to come back here and talk to a dummy. Captain Dumb for Brains. Slick Jr. the Third. So wait, wouldn't that make him the Fourth? Who ever heard of a Jr. also being the Third? That doesn't make any sense. Maybe it's some sort of weird elven naming convention. Like how in Iceland, your last name is always whatever your father's name is, and then son or daughter.
A little blue monster with wings, though. He was really sort of cautious, not aggressive at all. It's weird. Maybe if I can find its den, I can get some help. But the only problem with that plan is that he jumped over a wall that's too high for me to get over.
Holy cow, is that all that's holding you back? Sheesh, why didn't you say something sooner? I'm sure you could blow that wall to pieces with one of Slicky's super deluxe bombs. Here, I'll push one through this crack.
Another bomb? That's how this whole mess started.
Well, since you seem a little short in the idea department, just take the bomb and try it. I know it's gonna work. Even you can't blow it with this bomb.
And you couldn't have thought of that.
Come on, hurry up! I think I'm running out of air. If you can get me out of this mess, I'd even kiss ya.
I think the lack of oxygen in there is affecting what's left of your brain. Just sit tight and count your blessings that I don't kill you when this is all over.
How is there less oxygen where Slick's standing than there is where Male's standing? It's the same general area, there's just like a stalactite there. So yeah, you couldn't have just thought to give me the bomb in the first place, so now I have to trek all the way back with 35% health and hopefully not die. I can probably take one more hit with Male and then switch back to Tat, and then by that point I should be close enough to the town that I can just heal. You always want to heal in town instead of using fruit if at all possible, just because it's way cheaper than consuming fruit. It's one gold piece per hit point, whereas the cheapest healing item, I think, I don't know, the orange is the heals you the least, it heals you 20, but I don't know what they actually sell for. Not going to worry about that bat. I guess I can go ahead and switch back to Tat since he technically has more health. I did not see any fossils. That is false advertising. I'm trying to say and less because I noticed it was way worse than usual in the last video. It's a bad habit to get into. Like, I tell myself that that's another like that's just as bad as Amina. I tell myself that silence is the opposite of golden, that silence is the worst thing I can do while recording an LP or streaming, but, there I go again. But, you know, natural silence is preferable to a bunch of unpleasant verbal tics. In my opinion, at least. It's a tough habit to wean yourself off of. Okay, we made it. No work for the wear. Let us drop this bomb. How do I do that exactly? God, all I have is a banana. That's horrible. Alright, and I don't have any equipment for Tat. Wow. Okay, I think I have to be right up next. Oh, there we go. It just does it automatically. It appears that this would be the best place to detonate the bomb. Wow. Talk about your contained demolition. That's like one of those buildings that they implode. And it just falls down in a neat straight line into itself. Whoa, look at all this stuff. Oh, good timing. I was just complaining about how little stuff I have. Hammer, eh? Gold bullion, eh? I don't think that would make very good soup. I don't know. I mean, I know they make liquor with gold in it, but that's just like gold flakes. And I don't think it adds much to the flavor of the liquor. What's it called? Like Goldenheimer or something? Gold. Gold schnapps? Goldenmeister. But if you make a whole soup out of gold, I don't know. That seems neither tasty nor healthy. I guess it's just a sign of opulence. Like, cower before me, mortals. I am eating an $80,000 meal. I don't know how much gold that would be. I think the Red Bull should go into a line of energy soup. I think it's an untapped market. They could call it Red Bullion. I didn't make that joke up. I stole it from a podcast I listened to called No More Whoppers, which everyone should listen to. It is quite amusing. Well, I don't know if everyone should listen to it, but if your sense of humor is exactly like mine, and by now you should know whether it is or not, then check it out, nomorewhoppers.com. That's NOMOREWHOPPERS. It's a good source of Tiffany. And someone's messaging me on Steam, but I can't reply because I'm recording a video. How thoughtless of them. I am really low on health. Let's switch back to mail for the dialogue, if nothing else. Well, actually, let's see what Slick's interaction with Tad is like. Well, that was easy.
Man, do you think you could have taken any longer? Grandma Slicky could have dug me out with a spoon by this time. But I'll take a hammer over a spoon any day, see?
I guess.
Mr. Slick! I don't believe it! I've been had! Again!
I love how he calls him Mr. Slick. Let's see if I can make it to the town before I call it quits. This video's getting a little bit long. I want to wrap it up here fairly soon. It's got to be pretty close. I don't know. Maybe it's not as close as I thought. Well, okay. Let's go ahead and call the quits here. That's, 18 minutes for this segment. Probably about 5 minutes for the preview. Yeah, okay. Alright, so this has been Let's Play Popful Mail Redux. Tune in on Wednesday for the next episode, where we get to the Gaul Town. We might catch up with Slick, and we will hopefully buy some fruit and equipment. I'm Duke the Bump. See you all later.